Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading History of Waterdeep 5, which I found in a commoner's house in North Baldur's Gate. History of Waterdeep, Age 2, The Lord's Rule begins. In his 112th winter, Agaron had a sharp disagreement with Rorlor, who was then warlord of Waterdeep. Rorlor wanted to use Waterdeep's acquired wealth and strength of arms to create a northern empire, with Waterdeep its capital and Rorlor its ruler, and gathered armies for the purpose. Agaron defied him before all the people, and Rorlor ordered the mage to be chained. Agaron magically struck aside all who sought to lay hands on him. In a fury, Rorlor struck at the mage with his own blade. Agaron rose into the air, just out of reach, and as the infuriated warlord slashed repeatedly at his rising feet, gestured. Rorlor's blade transmuted in his hand from steel into a hissing serpent, which promptly bit him. The warlord died of the venom before the shock people assembled there. Agaron then gathered all the captains of Waterdeep's army and all the seniors of the families of Waterdeep. While runners sought to bring them to the castle, flames roared and crackled in the warlord's empty chair of state at Agaron's bidding, so that no one sat there. Then, at a gesture from the mage, the flames were gone as though they had never been, leaving the chair unmarked. Agaron seated himself, then, and proclaimed himself the first lord of Waterdeep, saying that henceforth wisdom and not armed might would rule in the city. He would gather some few, in secret, to rule as lords with him, masked and disguised when they appeared to the people, but equal to him in authority, and free of coercion by any, himself included. These lords were to be drawn from all walks of life in the city, and could serve as long as they wished. The people heard and agreed, and for the next 200 years Agaron ruled Waterdeep with his unknown fellow lords. Over the years the masked lords were a group of sometimes 5, 6, or 7, who appeared seldom and said little. Some whispered that they were Agaron's servants, or even magical automatons controlled by the old mage. Still, Agaron's justice was swift and fair, his laws good, his guardsmen polite, and just as ready to help as apprehend, and the people approved. The years passed in peace and prosperity. The north was open to humans. Roads built under Agaron's direction linked it together from the ruins of the fallen kingdom, which had been shattered by goblin races' attacks before men were numerous in the north, to the cities that would later become Am. Waterdeep grew fivefold in size and wealth. From all over the realms folk began to come to the crown of the north, drawn by money, and among them came those who rob, cheat, and steal. When word of doings extended beyond simple theft to deception in workmanship, and the appearance of many fly-by-night impostor craftsmen reached Agaron's ears, he called together the senior merchants, the noble ones, and suggested that they form guilds, as was done in the far south, to police the unscrupulous of their own professions. Some resisted or were furious, but most saw the advantages of such an arrangement, particularly if they were free to set matters up themselves, and not have less favorable arrangements forced upon them. The guilds were created forthwith. Twice more the city walls were expanded, as Waterdeep continued to grow in size and prosperity. Its merchants traveled the world over, bringing back exotic goods from afar, and spreading word of the city's wealth to remote lands. In the south some listened with an eye to conquest, or at least plunder, but swords were already out in those southern lands in a time of widespread strife, and no invaders came. Agaron's health eventually failed, and he died. He was buried with ceremony in his tower, which was secured against thieves and fools. Those who learned the arts arcane from the old mage cast the most potent protective magics known upon his home and resting place, which many believe remains inviolate today. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate, History of Waterdeep 5.